We've designed Surface as a modern standby device that fine-tunes power management dynamically, right down to the individual hardware components. In the next few minutes, we'll explain your two power management options within modern standby for Windows 10. Connected standby for always-on computing, and disconnected standby for longer battery life. We'll also cover your power configuration options within modern standby. To check the power states available on your device, you can do powerconfig/A. That will show you that connected standby is now available and S3 is not, because it's not necessary. The main benefit here with connected standby is instant resume. Just like your phone, you get full PC capabilities immediately. When you think about low power states in most PCs, you think about S4, hibernation, or S3, sleep, that still has power to the RAM. With modern Windows and Surface, we want it to remain connected while still using less power than traditional sleep and having much faster resume times. So compared to S3, connected standby fine-tunes power management right down to the individual hardware components. You want your device to be in the lowest power state for as long as possible. This state is called drips. From drips, Surface is able to wake up small portions of the system at the time, just enough to handle background tasks such as an incoming email or other traffic coming across the network. Other devices, such as cameras and sensors, are never turned on. After this, it returns back to drips. Let me demo this for you. If I press the power button, my device goes into connected standby. Then if I grab my pen and click the pen button, the device immediately wakes up through Bluetooth and launches OneNote so that I can take notes. So that is connected standby. But if you don't need your application, such as email, to keep connected to the network and stay current like in your phone, you can extend your battery life and still keep instant resume by opting for a second mode of modern standby, new with Windows 10 and called disconnected standby. To do that, we'll just open the PC settings, go to System, Power and Sleep, and then check these two boxes that say stay connected to Wi-Fi while asleep. This has disabled Wi-Fi. So now if I go back and query my power configuration, I'll see that now disconnected standby is available and connected standby is no longer available. Now let's look at the power options. The first thing I notice is that I have a lot less power options available on my Surface devices than on my other devices in my organization. The reason for that is because Surface intelligently manages the rest of the components that are not configurable through the UI. One thing you'll notice is that if you configure through group policies, or if you use power configuration commands, or even registry keys, those will still take effect. This is not a good thing. The rule of thumb is if the devices are not configurable through the UI, don't configure them through any other method. The only setting that we still recommend to configure, and that is available in the UI for Windows 10 but was not for Windows 8.1, is to set the hibernation timeout. Setting this will tell us after how many minutes of connected or disconnected standby, your device will enter hibernation and stop consuming power. The Surface image has this configured to 2 to 4 hours, but you may change that value to anything that suits your users. We hope this explains how power management and modern standby work with Surface, and all the available options. Don't forget to check back on Microsoft Mechanics for more demos on Surface management and design. Bye for now.